That is a thing of beauty. That is a thing of beauty. Like, holy shoot. That is... All right. Let's get this intro going, yeah? What's up, Internet? This is Weasley coming at you with a game I was actually really exciting for. I was really excited for, and holy shoot, I finally get a chance to play it. Tales of Berseria. Now, for a little backstory, I played through Tales of Symphonia around the time one of my favorite YouTubers started Let's Playing it, and that actually had a hand in inspiring me to get on YouTube. So there's a little bit of backstory. I loved Tales of Symphonia, and then I saw this game, and when I read the description, I was like, a personal story? Like, a story that focuses on, like, almost exclusively on the characters, and how they deal with their circumstances, including the main character, who literally has an evil inside them and struggles to live with it. Like, I was like, that kind of stuff. Like, let's go. Let's do a little character exploration. Character discovery. Like main character eventually learns to be human according to the description on the PlayStation Store, and I was like, let's go. So before I bore you to death, English, because, you know, I'm a dub. We're off to a strong start. What do you think? I also played the demo like a nerd. Here we go. Let's go. DLC? Let me just go with new game. There's no need to open the store. Let's just get in. Let's just get in. Bow difficulty. There's simple, normal, moderate, hard. Okay, moderate. Input buffer. Short, I'm a fighting game player. Yes, subs on. Simple enough. Rotation speed. All right. This looks good. Let's get it. Bad things always happen under the blood moon.
You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please.
You'll be just fine with these. Celica enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Celica is safe. It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Laffy's older sister, and you're a student.
Can I talk now? Ragnar's a Bloodedge's sister. I am so sorry.
On that day, the world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
So this is
Laffy,
a revenge...
Time to wake up. Okay. Morning! I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today.
Until then, you stay in bed, got it?
What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape.
Sorry, you'll have to wait.
Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to.
Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money will have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my students' abilities. Sorry to put you in a spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening.
Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
Ah, shoot, tutorials! I don't need those. Well, I actually do need tutorials because I don't really know what I'm doing. I mean, I'm familiar with these games, but just in case I mess something up. So our mission, right out there. I know about a mini map. I know about an area map. I know about what, actually an event list. I'm not, oh wait, that's more or less a quest journal.
If I'm on the hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Luffy's medicine. So I can't mess this up.
Oh, shoot. It's my controller. Let me fix that. Can I fix that real quick? System. Options. Yep, here we are. Speakers only. There you go. Don't need hear, no, don't, we don't need to hear double. Dang, this game's pretty. Holy shoot.
Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. Maybe he's just worn out? That does it. I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. That ought to pick him right up. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers and weariness alike.
Now, I'm going to sound really bad, but I'm a sucker for the mom character, or just any parental figure of a character. But that might be because I'm an older brother, and oftentimes I relate to that the most. But
I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest. I don't have a lot of money to spare, but like Arthur always says, battles are won and lost with the preparations made before the first strike.
I see. Ooh, all right, apple gels. I just buy. What? Wait, I already had three. I just can't read things. I just can't read signs, apparently. So at this point, she's 16. No comment on how anime characters are portrayed. I honestly would guess like my age considering how, because you know, she kind of came off as the mom character like right there, but I am really teetering on the line of talking myself to a hole. Oh boy. Side quest.
The demon blight is a punishment sent to us by the Empyreans for forgetting the old prayers.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
Right then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16.
I feel that on the spiritual level. Like, I'm not a kid. So I guess here is, you know, outside of the village, we have four apple gels. You probably wouldn't have hurt to buy one more, but whatever, right?
This area looks promising.
I see a collectible. I pick up the collectible. A mushroom. Used in medicine, so there may be crafting in this one. There wasn't crafting in Symphonia, but let's see, right? Oh, it's just a wall here. Whoa, there's something here. I did not take the time to read that.
There! Prickle Boar!
Come on, let's go. Yeah, I'm gonna need this. This is audible gold. And I am glad we're gonna be hearing this a lot. Let's get it. I see. I see. That's how it works. All right. Block automatically. Oh!
Is that all?
Alright. Yeah, I already know that.
Yeah, that's how it's done.
So,
the cold weather's been terrible on everyone's crops.
Heart to heart.
But at least the city will buy our prickle boar meat now. Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them, but they can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred with more docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkle boars? Nah, doesn't sound appetizing. What about pickle boar? Yeah, pickle boar! That's a cute name. Maybe too cute, though. We wouldn't want to discourage people from eating them.
Okay, The heart to hearts, that's why I'm calling them, because of Symphonia, are actually pretty awesome. And here we don't actually know what to do. We don't have a move. Esiyo, you can't get the first strike. This ain't Paper Mario. Another one. I see. So when I'm empty, I can still go on the offensive, but defense is out. Oh, I misinterpreted that. If they block, they'll block, and I'll be knocked back. Oh, alright. That is cool as heck. But they do use... Ow. Come on. Why do I do that? Wait. Ow. I wasn't paying attention.
Arthur, second mask. Know your foes and strike where they're weak.
Come on. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah. Just gotta get it down to somewhat muscle memory, you know? Using arts with no souls comes with a number of... Alright. I see. So stun is the way to go. Oh, that just marks a chest that's been opened. This here is a save point. Let me go ahead and save real quick. Yes. Oh, I don't have anything to break that. I see a boar. I fight a boar. Another one? No. Why did I do that? Oh, all right. I wonder what other arts I have.
This should be enough to cover the medicine. I'd better bring these to the store.
But what the heck is over here? More importantly... There it is. Items. Arts. Okay. Terran Thorn, Gouging Spin, Harsh Rebuttal. They're all a Rising Moon. I just have to get up to level 4. Alright. Wait, I can customize like right here? Alright. Now go ahead and take a minute to customize this crud. go. Just play some foot. We just have these, like, just same, essentially. All right. Pro mode, manual. Full on manual. I didn't realize it was semi-auto. Fashion. All right. What the heck is this?
This place isn't safe. That hole's gotten bigger. I've told them 1,000 times they ought to build a fence, but they keep saying it's forbidden land. Even Celica used to scare me with it. She was always, "This is a gateway to the underworld." Well, I'm too old to keep falling for that nonsense.
Now watch her fall at some point and end up in the underworld. It'd be hilarious to me. I'm a terrible person, I'm well aware. But I have a sense of irony. It doesn't look like there's anything terribly of interest here, so let's just make our way back, right? Already saved, so there's no real need. Four! Okay. Okay, this is actually kind of important. Okay, so Terran Thorn, Gouging Spin. I think, is there like a stage 5 or something? Here, so Rising Moon, it looks like Tearing Thorn can naturally combo into that. And of course, when I saw a Slicing Foot there, I'll have to further examine that, but before I make any more decisions on my moveset. I think I'll wait till the first major boss. Or all wait, this.
The boars I hunted. Are you there? Maxim 3. Never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle.
Dang. That's pretty intense. Tutorial. In the arts, focus on damage and attack range, but use wars in the martial arts. Searing Edge is effective against beasts. Gain advantage by exploiting the enemy's weak spots. Let me start with Terran Thorn. And then we have this. All right. Looks like we're good. You know, what am I doing? Alright. Given the nature of that, give a bit of a, let's see here. All right, this looks good. Just have a loop back. Let's see here. Give him slicing foot. Red Moon. Terran Thorn should be O2. All right. Well,
an exorcist art.
Pride and anxiety, pity for the enemy, thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
You good? Got two different Arthur? Voices.
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine.
Yeah, that should be plenty.
I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of...
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
They don't question if they can fly.
Why?
They know.
Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
All right.
Hurry back. I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me.
All right. So I got no money off that, but... Hey, I got some grade, right? I consumed it. How'd I sell it? Oh wait, heart.
I wonder if those prickle boars were brothers. Maybe I should have let them go. But then how would I pay for Laffy's medicine? Hunting took care of that. And it means food for us as well. I had no other choice. It was a rational decision. But the fact that I'm still worrying about it shows that my feelings are getting the better of me.
The icon for the heart to heart is so dang small. Super easy to miss.
Here for groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out hunting.
Yeah, it was a good haul.
Look at you, Lady Breadwinner. If you were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah? You ought to do something about your style, then.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb.
So get a new one.
And what do you know?
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
Oh, shoot.
What? Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
Oh.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh. What is wrong with Midgand? I mean, don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
Dang.
But we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore.
Jeez!
Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, here, on the house.
You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche.
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious.
Please, this is life or death for me.
but I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
Who cares what people think? The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right.
You may need new friends. That one may be a little
Rocky
too vain.
Must be starving by now. I better hurry home.
Like, that sounds cold, but let's be real. That seemed a little bit dramatic and all that. Like, yo, we don't need all that. This is not the house. I believe it's like right down here. Like, we have like the most secluded place. I guess low-key, Voa doesn't like people. Neither does Arthur, apparently. Uh-oh. We're going to fight some demons? Oh.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. And the baby you carried. Oh, drat. I forgot to bring your princessias. I know how much you, Mom, and Dad all loved those flowers. And I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some from the cape tomorrow.
Holy shoot! Like, holy that is actually, that's actually kinda heavy. Let's just get in the house. Let's just get in the house before you just, jeez.
Welcome home, Velvet.
Luffy, I told you to stay in bed.
I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the ocean. See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the waves. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Luffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh, you really can talk to Molochim, can't you?
Yeah, Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him. I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world. I'll hunt and chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you. I wish I could do that.
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take, oh, 20 years tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh yeah? You better prove it to me then. Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks,
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove.
Not gonna lie, that scene was flippin' adorable, man. That scene was, like, man. She really is a mom to him. Oh, I can ignite this.
It's so easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know, but just for today?
Fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once, and I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet.
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there?
Man.
There you go. Not spicy hot, but oh so delicious.
I saw
Nico today, and she had very important things to talk about. She's coming over in the next couple days, so be on your best behavior.
I will. I'm glad you've got a good friend.
Yeah, we've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Luffy, you know, if there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big Sister all about it, right?
A girl?
You're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older girl to keep you under control. And she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen is a success at life.
Knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me?
Dang!
I've got enough on my mind. For one thing, I've got to cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men, I just don't see what's so...
Ah, jeez.
Luffy, what's wrong?
Jump down. Check on this dude. Yo.
Are you all right? I'll bring you some water.
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all. And it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah, but what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you too. I want you to be happy, that's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready.
Holy shoot. Let's get cooking. Cook stuff up, you know? Cutscene time.
Good boy. You didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise. Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Yeah. Just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet? May I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course.
That is a lot for a night.
A Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? You better not have gone to the village alone. I bet your fever hasn't even gone down.
Dang it! So now we gotta find him. Is there a run button? I don't think we really need one now that I think about it.
Hey, has Lafayette been here?
No, I haven't seen him.
That sounds kind of suspect.
Wait, that's one of Arthur's.
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand?
He's a beast. And
he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet, I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest.
The mischief this kid gets to.
I know. He might have gone to the cape to pick flowers.
I'm pretty sure the cape is that way. Go ahead, put up a save. All right. This is pretty. Oh, that's actually a really big cow. Well, it seems fairly normal for cows. But that's a really furry cow. I actually went the wrong way. Oh wait, the cape is past the forest, the other forest. I'm just a goof who forgot that quick. That's just a really satisfying sound to me. I'm not actually saving that way, but hey.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to be another Scarlet Night.
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago. But what is it anyway?
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one by watching the movements of the stars. According to legend, a crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof of humanity's sins.
You sure know a lot about it.
Lafayette taught me just a few minutes ago.
A few minutes.
Lafayette? Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
All right. Dude really says, sounds like John Ark from Ruby. But I don't know for sure. I don't know for sure if it's the same voice actor. I mean, it could be, but I don't know. Like, it could be, it couldn't be, but honestly, it doesn't super concern me. I just know the character is really cool. Oh, yeah, dude. Just spam the moon. Oh, all right. So you string together more combos.
Fluffy!
Velvet, can you walk? How's your fever?
I'm fine. I was just taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Lafayette. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the Cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
Remember how we went out together to pick Princessias on the morning of Celica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only 4, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of course I did. Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too?
You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you. He'll help the world. He's quite the guy.
That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe.
I know. I'm sorry, sis.
But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of Princessia were blooming.
I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica.
That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what Princessia flowers signify?
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come.
Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Luffy.
Yeah. Me too, sis.
The levels of wholesome we're hitting are off the charts.
How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Luffy?
Apple boo? What's that?
Grated apples. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart and juicy and crisp. Eating it always made me feel better.
Well, apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
When I was a baby, I would always say boo-boo when I wanted to eat an apple.
So that's where the name comes from. Wait, you called apples boo-boo? You must have been a strange baby.
You used to do the same thing. When Celica and I heard you, we laughed so hard.
Boo!
I should not have laughed quite as hard as I did. Let's get it! Let's get it! I really should be using Searing Edge more because they're weak to fire. As I just kind of stumble my way around. Yo! I don't think we need to save. Now watch me get mopped up by a boss.
Just look at all these. This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy, do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to... Oh! A demon!
Set. Run! No matter how much it hurts, run!
Velvet!
Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't!
Well,
stop! Face me, demon!
Oh! Luffy, I thought I told you to run! Oh, dang. Not good. Took you long enough.
How did I get home?
Velvet!
Luffy!
You're all right.
Sorry. It's all my fault.
No. If you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Scarlet Knight? What's going on? Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't!
We better move. First, is there a heart-to-heart? Nope. Let's go.
What's happening?
I forgot that factoid from the intro.
Fluffy, where are you?
Yeah.
Time to be scared. I have to find Luffy.
Oh, shoot. Oh, shoot.
No. The village.
Shoot. So it's safe to say that either that, given a lack of common sense, we'd go to where we fought that one demon.
Don't give up. Never give up.
Jeez. Thread that needle. Dang. Like the sound of one of the guys behind me? He was like, shoot. Well, I was like, shoot. Moving. Moving my butt. It might be a good time to put up a save.
Sentiment to cast off.
Oh no.
Velvet, run! Arthur!
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lockus' life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
let him go. This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you have not changed. Ever a slave to emotion. Feeds on demons.
Arthur.
A Therian.
Arthur!
All right, let's get. James!
Take a look around. Demon blight has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorius Colbrand, will end your pain. Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer, Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
pay!
Well, at least you got a level up outfit. I see. That's interesting.
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years, I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him. And be my brother's vengeance. Where is he? First, there will be a test. It will decide if you are worth teaching.
Well. Oh yeah, I saw that. I managed to get the stun. Oh, alright. Throw a quick step before an enemy attacks. Attack won't. You only do 1 damage and I'll recover some skill. Well, some soul, I mean.
Here I come. If you are not, I will kill you. Ready yourself.
That's on me. I'm just pressing buttons on you. A lot of damage.
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of... Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is. You may find him in the capital city of Logris in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malachim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcists quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcist's Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people and a sword against demons, Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafiset.
Indeed. But his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
Escape? So that's your game. Fine. I don't care what the world thinks of me. What matters is my vengeance against Artorias. That's all.
I have shattered your yoke. We must hurry.
All right. Prodigy's Glassite. I see. Oh, I see. All right. Oh, can't even look into my art. I'm at 300 HP. And the music here, it's a jam.
You will need equipment. There are weapons in the room ahead.
So basically, we're leading a resistance. This is a really long hallway. Dang.
No one raised the alarm.
I can see that.
Take what you need from here.
Okay, bossy.
It looks like they kept prisoners' effects in here.
Rope. This will be useful. Quite a blade.
I know that sword. Stormhowl. What is it doing here?
Well, it's too big for me.
You're not taking it? It's a celebrated masterpiece.
And if I can't use it, it's worthless.
Magical as heck!
Are you ready then?
What's going on here?
Speaking of metal, let's get it.
He's no ordinary soldier. He's an exorcist orderly.
Blast him in the face.
You didn't even flinch.
I already told you. I am his Moloch no longer.
Is there a ship waiting?
So you already know we're on an island.
Yes. I've learned that this is a prison island for violent criminals, and that there are scores of demons locked away here. Demons say lots of things when they don't want you to eat them.
The prison has docks at both the front and rear entrances. Our ship is on the back side.
Got it. The back docks.
So already we're looking pretty flippin' metal. So now I can look to my art. So I have all my moves here. I've used Rising Moon, Tearing Thorn a lot. All right. I kind of need this save. And while I'm thinking about it, are these apple gels still good?
What is this thing?
That's a special mass of mana. Think of them as the souls belonging to a family of Malachim. They appeared all over after the Advent 3 years ago.
Another after effect of the Advent.
If you collect enough of them, you might be able to solicit the cooperation of a Moloch family.
And I'm supposed to take your word for it.
I'm not forcing you to do anything. Whether you collect them or not is up to you.
I might as well pick them up. I'll use every tool at my disposal.
Indeed. You'll have to if you want your revenge.
It looks like that way's just closed off, but there is a little collectible. Those are there, like, pick the like two of them, like one after
God's
the other,
coming.
Like that.
Two of them this way.
Did you hear? The path around the island is off limits now. They say the ground's weak and could collapse.
The path that goes under the watchtower? That's all right, nobody uses it anyway.
True, but it was a nice shortcut to the docks.
They are idiots, really.
Shortcut to the docks. Under the watchtower.
A number of guards have gone missing. It would seem we have intruders on the island.
All right, let's get it.
All exorcists, break into two groups and converge at the front and rear gates.
Understood. No one will get past us.
except one Velvet and one serious. And one yes, Ex-Malak.
This isn't going to be easy.
Then we'll need reinforcements of our own. Where are the cells?
They should be on this floor. You plan on involving the other prisoners?
I'll use any tool I have at my disposal.
I mean, we better shoot. So our mission is like right here.
Who in the blazes are you?
Tutorial. I see. Level 5. Actually, a lot of HP he's got there. The little one's got more?
Here I go!
This guy seems more aggressive.
We're finished here. Let's go.
All right. Pick a door, any door. As far as which door to open, I'm not sure. There's a couple demon guys. So, how exactly do we go about opening this?
Listen up! I'm opening every door to every cell. We're getting off this island.
What the hell? You serious?
Into two groups and rush the front and rear gates. Break through the gates and you'll have a ship.
But aren't they guarded by exorcists? I mean, that pirate Von Eifried's the only one who's ever broken out of here.
And he didn't pull it off just by himself. He was hauled out by some old exorcist named Melchior or something.
Von Eifried? And Melchior?
I won't force you! You want to rot in here, then rot.
I'm with you. Anything's better than another day in this rat
Let's
hole.
Do it. I'm going home to my family.
Me too.
Yeah.
Let me out, girl.
Rogues like us are always
I'm
up for a
I'm sick of the slop they feed us.
Ceres. Draw the attention of the guards. In the meantime, we'll search for that watchtower. From there, we can follow the outer path down to the docks.
So you're leaving them all to their fates?
I told you. We'll use any tool I need.
Okay, but can we talk about the cooperation between human and demon? Actually, kind of cool. Interesting here.
You're not going to escape?
Don't underestimate the exorcists. They're all gonna die like dogs. Or goblins.
This abbey that's in charge of this place. They're that amazing.
Amazing doesn't even begin to cover it. The Exorcists of the Abbey joined forces with the Kingdom of Midgand. And they've got the whole world in their pocket. They're merciless. They hunt down any human who becomes a demon. Going against them means taking on the whole world.
And I bet I know who's at the top.
Those who get captured and sent here are the lucky ones. We may be monsters, but at least we have our lives.
Sure. Until they get fed to me. Thanks for the info.
Even if you manage to escape this place, thousands of exorcists controlling powerful Malakim will be out there waiting for you. There's nowhere for you to run. Nowhere.
I'm not going to run. I'll gladly die, as long as I take Artorias with me.
So we have one severely and rightfully ticked off Velvet. I mean, he kind of did her, like, way, way dirty.
Dear me, not a word of apology? What is wrong with you people? There I was, sleeping like a sweet babe, when suddenly... From paradise down to hell! No worse, a grimy prison cell! You see why I'm not feeling well.
And you are?
Hooray! You asked! I'm thrilled to introduce to you the wise sorceress who travels the 11 seas, who scoffs at the might of dragons! None other than the acclaimed, the illustrious, Magikikikafi Ludin Dodin Nolaroon Du! Maggie Lou for short.
Maggie Lou?
No, Ma! Like Soggy Shoe or Doggy Doo, or call me any of those things and I'll turn you into a froggy stew! I suppose you'll never understand. People can be so tragically unlearned. But hey, like I care!
I can't believe she snuck up on me. Who is she?
This is no ordinary prison. We must be cautious. Trust no one. She said she's a powerful witch.
Did she have a Moloch tethered?
No, I didn't sense Malakim around her. She's an ordinary human, I think.
Then she's an ordinary magician, not a witch. If she tries to trick me again, I'll crush her and be done with it.
Dang. Though she might actually be like best character so far. That was the hoot in half. So where did it go? We have a save point. Let me go ahead and put up a save. I have no clue what's up next. So we may as well just keep going, right? Oh. I got turned around. Whoops. Here, door number one. Oh, this guy's a war tiger. these guys chilling? Really? This is really, really weird, and I love it. Like, we got a demon and we got a zombie. So, door number two. I'm glad I came around here. Picked up Sage. I see. So, a little bit later, another one of those will spawn in. Yep, this is door number three. Here's like, just like, prison blocks. You know, the music here kind of reminds me of it, but kind of calls to mind like Mortal Kombat almost. Like, I want to say Mortal Kombat 9. Two more of these? Right. So let's try this door. There we go. Going up makes a little bit more sense. Another save. Just gonna put one up right here. Since, you know, saves a little bit of backtracking should I die a painful death. I see. I mean, I think I better wait till we have like two official party members, including Velvet. Dying. He got laid. Everyone just got laid out flat. What's up, bro? More?
This one, he's a demon. Get ready.
See this? Deception.
You're not human.
Neither are you.
True enough.
See this?
All right, let's go.
All stop.
Chips in the blades already. Brittle these exorcist knives. I've got to reclaim Storm Howl.
Storm Howl? That sword we found?
You found it? Where? Do you have it? Please tell me.
It's in a storage room. Down below.
Down below? You have my thanks.
He's an odd demon. If things settle down, we'll miss our window. Hurry.
I see. Master skills are always on a piece of equipment. I see.
Stormhowl. Could that demon be...
What is it?
Nothing. That demon swordsman was just strange. He was so full of fury, but when you started talking about that sword, his manner changed completely.
Don't think too much about it. He's a demon, after all.
The prisoners here are all so unusual. Except for you.
Forget it. Like I care what a Moloch thinks of me.
Alright, let's get it. Just double check the corner. You trying to fight me?
Here.
Not free simple.
Getting out of here comes first.
An amber blade. Yeah, I saw that.
Gate to the docks locked down. We can't break through.
The tower should be just ahead.
There we go. Blood blade. You're so close to maxing this guy out already. I think I'll wait. What are these titles? Yeah, I'll check the last of that later.
We've just about quelled this riot. You won't be getting away.
All right, let's get it. Dang.
We're finished here. Let's go.
All right, I'm slowly learning how this works.
The prisoners are doomed.
Time is short. We need to get down to the path.
Got a cup of coin. So I actually have to hold up for this. Right, got some money.
Oh.
path has collapsed. That rope won't do any good here. Wait, you're not seriously going to try it, are you?
He fell further than this back at the shrine.
I see you are truly committed to this. You're strong. I would almost think you made an oath. It's a ritual that grants special power if the oath taker abides by certain restrictions. The harsher the restrictions, the greater the power one may command. In a very real sense, an oath is a sort of curse, right?
Well, guess what? You're the ones who did this to me.
I am aware. That is why I chose you.
Chose me? All right. Wait. So this one actually became...
I'll end this quickly.
Oh, all right. Ow. Take a second. Go ahead and put up a save, just in case it's boss time. All right.
Are you sure? This way leads to the main entrance.
If they know you're here, they'll have found your ship by now. The guards expect us at the rear, not the front.
She's got a point. Just in case there's no jerkishly placed orbs here.
We're almost there.
That's enough.
Oscar, I had no idea an Exorcist Praetor had been assigned to this island.
Just in case.
You surprise me, Ceres. Aiding criminals now, are you? Did Lord Artorias request this?
No, I'm acting on my own.
A mullet with free will? And yet, I sense someone's strings guiding you.
Hold on. Praetor is far more dangerous than an orderly.
I'm all out of subterfuge. And besides, if we can't overpower this one, our end goal was hopeless to begin with.
You're a demon, but still a lady, so I'll show you due respect. I am Oscar Dragonia, Praetor of the Abbey of the Holy Midgand Empire. Who might you be?
Huh.
All right. Graceless demon it is, then.
Oh my goodness.
Lord Artorias himself taught me the ways of purification. How will you fare against them?
Lead us to the wound! First aid! You will not fall down. Burning wings! Got things on it!
I'm actually really hurt. Turn up an snap, Joe. Jeez.
It is my sacred duty to sweep the demons from this earth.
Dang, really? Okay, just gonna equip this. Let's use Bloody Boot. All right. Let's go.
All right. Graceless demon it is then.
Yep.
Lord Artorias himself taught me the ways of purification. How will you fare against them?
Dang.
I will have to expend a Moloch or two for this.
More of your vaunted reason. Wounds are fatal. Please, consume me. I'm not about to. My form is bound by an oath whose price is my life. The time has come to pay. Feeding on my form will grant you strength, the strength to press forward. I ask only that you devour me. Why? A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet. This was Laffy's. That is why I cannot abide it. This frozen world, this frozen people, aren't just that stubborn of a woman. Hurry, before my life fades. Do it now. I offer no apology or thanks.
I need neither. Our wishes. Are one and the same. I treasured those days. When you and I. And Arthur were. Together.
hard, the lady. Dang, really?
Here I come.
She absorbed that Moloch's power to wield as her own? I've never seen such a demon.
Just gonna heal up real quick. Well, I heal. Okay. So take a second. Take an alpha cell. Figured it'd be resistant to fire.
Apologies, but I can't let a nasty demon like you roam freely now, can I?
Velvet. That's my name. You can give Artorias my regards. Velvet Crow, and I will devour demon, Moloch, and exorcist alike. I am a monster. I am a Therian.
From the tower, I thought, this is it, Moggy Lou. This is the end!
It would have been less risky if you hadn't suddenly appeared and jumped on my back. Oh, hey, it's you. It's thanks to you that Storm Howl is back in my care. Rokurodon gets it. At your service. This blade is my life. I owe you a great debt, one I vow to repay.
Yes, yes, she's a peach and a model citizen. Can we get our move on? I think they're just about done massacring the rioters!
The docks are just ahead. Give me a hand.
Alright. And she leveled up. That smiley seat? Nah, it doesn't look like it. But I did get a buttload of grade out of that. So I guess I did well. I see. That's actually a handy tip. You'd probably be able to figure out yourself, but nice. Really? It comes with HP restoration and can heal? But it can also... But I've noticed that it slowly drained mine. see. Oh, yeah. Drains HP, but grants additional abilities based on the enemy type. It sees it's so very much a risk-reward type of deal.
Guess the weather's feeling as crummy as I am.
Careful. Sea's looking mighty choppy.
Are you a sailor?
No, but I do know the difference between a sail and a rudder.
I'll take what I can get. Do what you can.
You're leaving without a proper crew?
Very well, then. I certainly owe you this much, at least.
Brave words. But 10 minutes in this storm, and you'll lose all sense of direction.
No, we won't. Ships have compasses for a reason.
So it's rot in a jail cell, or rot in a fish tummy? Welp! Guess it's your lucky day, fishies!
I'm coming for you, Artorias.
This game. Hang on, beast. Oh boy. Oh, all right, gotta ground him.
You really are a box of horrors, aren't ya?
Sorry. If I had a weapon, I would have helped. I promise.
You're wearing one.
Oh, nah, I can't use this. Sorry, long story.
And the child?
The little brat? Scampered off somewhere.
You ought to be scampering off yourselves.
My debt is not yet repaid. Until it is, I will not leave your side.
I can hardly scamper off without knowing from whence I'm scampering. We're lost, stranded, shipwreck survivors, no?
Well, then I expect this might come in handy.
A map? Was that left by the child?
Looks to me like we're in Northgand.
Northgand? Then if we're to reach the capital in Midgand, we've no choice but to patch up our ship.
What are your plans once you reach Logris? Something worth breaking out of prison for.
Oh, can't we stand around and chat somewhere nicer? Somewhere with soup to warm the body, tales to warm the heart?
There's a city called Helavis nearby. I can't promise there much for conversation, but we'll find food and a ship right there.
All right, we have our destination. Now you tell me. Now the game tells me about that. And then there's a world map. Let Land of Dancing White.
Velvet, you know that kid? I thought I heard you call him by name.
No, I don't know any Malakim. Not anymore.
Anymore?
What?
Well, whoever he was, there was something different about him, that's for sure.
You can say that again. Using healing arts on a demon without being ordered to?
And he stole that compass, too. For being an exorcist Moloch, he's a greedy little imp.
Well, we did help ourselves to a certain map of his, so...
I consider myself an island of virtue in this sea of wickedness.
I suppose.
Come on, it's not funny if you agree with me.
You think?
So this is how escaped prisoners behave.
The witch might be the best character here.
Mogilu, your way of speaking is as strange as your appearance.
Mogilu is her name.
I'm a witch. I must project a proper age and dignity. I have an image to maintain.
Self-improvement in all things, I suppose. So what's the difference between a spellcaster and a witch?
There are many, but mainly it's a matter of nuance. It's like the difference between being frugal and being miserly.
Ah, so a spellcaster is useful and a witch isn't, is that it? So I guess that makes you a witch right now.
You wound me! You're one to talk, Mr. Self-Improvement! Your words cut deeper than these northern winds!
So I just thought I'd to scope around. Aha! It's always worthwhile. It's always worthwhile. Go ahead and pull up a save. We still got time. We can keep it pushing.
Possible.
I never said I was human.
She's got a point. Come here. Another tutorial. Oh boy. Oh boy. The game is gonna kill me. The game is gonna kill me. I feel like I'm one of those really stubborn people who'll only run when there's like no other way to survive. Hold on, I'll deal with you later. All right, now come here.
Here I come.
Wrong button. I'm really sucking at this. Oh boy. No, thinking I could smack him in the field. Rosemary, knock out this pork. I didn't even do that.
Come on, really?
And with that final hit.
So nice to be free again, able to move these bones around like I want.
So, Rokuro, what got you all chained up in that mold hole?
Ties to home. It's complicated.
Oh-ho-ho! Then are you really sure you ought to be taking on further debts?
It's a teaching of House Rangetsu. Pay what you owe.
Well, what a civilized family you've got.
Were you in for long?
3 years, maybe. That's why I know so little about the state of the world.
Me too! Art-wielding Malakim! I've never seen such a thing! How much else have I missed? Used to be witches who had a monopoly on charms and hexes. Can you even comprehend what this'll do to business?
Should I even ask why you were imprisoned?
Ha! Bagged for unlicensed witchcraft. It was a tale of betrayal most wicked and foul! Care to hear more? You'll cry, I'll laugh, emotions will touch the rafters!
No, thank you.
Magulu might actually be like that's already she's probably like my favorite of the party. Yeah, I figured that. I see. That was kind of nice. I need a move to propel me over there. A life bomb. Nice. Gotta revive. Trying not to gush about the music.
Oh no, I'm in so much trouble, so much trouble. Won't somebody please help a kitty out, meow?
Oh look, another weirdo.
That thing talks?
What if it's a cat demon?
Simmer down, big man. She's just a cat. Haven't seen one in a good long while.
Cats? Is that different from a regular cat somehow?
It's complicated. Cats are a mysterious bunch. Just think of them as a special kind of Moloch. Sort of.
That works for me. I understand that they're hard to understand, at least.
Hey, I don't suppose you happen to be carrying any cat spirits on you. They look like this.
That's just like what I found at Titania.
Perfect. You could say they're kind of like our souls to us.
Cat spirits, huh?
Sometimes we call them kitten caboodles, too.
That's just foolish.
Really? Then how about kitty clumps? Anyway, one night we were having a feast so meowvelous, our souls flew right out of our bodies. That's why I need your help to find the cat spirits and use them to emeowsipate my friends.
Emeowsipate? Really?
It means to use cat spirits to free cats who are locked away in cats' boxes like these here, meow. Here you'd say apesipate. This one would be edoxipate. And finally...
Phew! I'm free, meow!
See? Emeowsipate!
By that logic, shouldn't it be ecatsipate?
Wow, you're way more clever than you look! For real! I guess I totally underestimated you. Please, our cat spirits got scattered far and wide, and so many sad cats are trapped without them.
Seek out the cat spirits and rescue our poor lost brothers and sisters, meow.
And why should I?
Please, think of the cats.
You know, cats have weird and mysterious powers. There's a good chance we might benefit by having them in our debt. We'll make it worth your while, I promise. And if we snub them, they might put a curse on us.
That has been known to happen.
Ew.
If we're doing all this traveling anyway, why not help them on the side?
Just remember that it's on the side.
I am thoroughly amused by this. One thing I love about the Tales games, even the menus have personality. So let's continue down the beaten path, right? Oh shoot, it's 4:30. At the next save point, I will have to cut it. That don't look good.
Exorcists.
Well, that's just inconsiderate. Word of the prison break couldn't have traveled so quickly.
I somehow doubt they'll just let us in looking the way we do.
We need disguises.
I apologize about earlier. I didn't mean to steal this.
The compass.
You okay with this? He could be working for the exorcists.
I'm following him.
Is he your dessert?
If necessary.
So this takes us to a cave, and it looks like a save point. All right. Now that that's saved up. All right. So that's gonna be it for this stream. I honestly had a lot of fun so far. I can't resist a good RPG. So, if you're new around here, leave a follow so you'll be notified whenever I go online. Usually I do fighting games. Mondays and Wednesdays are Street Fighter, Tuesdays, Thursdays, Tekken, and Friday is a free day, which I am reserving for Tales of Berseria. I'm having a blast, actually. Like, I might not look it, but I feel like I'm already getting into it. So, but the story isn't quite what I gathered, but that's what makes it all the better, right? So, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys Monday with Street Fighter, and, well, assuming my plan doesn't hit any dinks like it did this week. So, I'll see you guys Monday, hopefully, with Street Fighter. Thanks again for watching, and stay awesome, stay safe, and stay safe. Things getting kind of crazy. But I low-key feel like we already went past the climax, so everything should be chilling out soon. See you guys.